Welcome back to our series on ADAS calibrations featuring the ADASLink and the DAS 3000 by Hunter. Today we're going to be going over the procedures for doing front radar calibrations on this 2020 GMC Yukon Denali. The one thing that you're going to notice about this, it seems similar to the Ford video that you may have watched earlier where we did a windshield calibration. This is a little different though. We are going to be doing the front long range radar, which is our adaptive cruise control. The front bumper was replaced on this. Now there was no damage to the actual radar module, but they did take it off and reinstall it. They also did verify that it was installed correctly using the OEM specifications. We have no DTCs in the systems. There are no lights, but again, we always want to make sure that we're going through the calibrations anytime any of these modules is removed or reinstalled. So we're going to go through the calibration of that today. The really great part about this and watching this video is that this is going to apply to millions of vehicles on the road today. A lot of these radars that you're going to see from Ford, GM, and Stellantis all have the exact same procedure that is a drive procedure. We're going to go through this so you can see a little bit of the nuances, how it works, right after this. So the front radar on this one is in the lower left portion down here for that long range. Again, that's your adaptive cruise control. That's maintaining the distance from the car in front of you. No longer are you pressing coast or cancel or hitting the brakes. These cars will maintain that distance for you. So even if you set your cruise control to 65 miles an hour, if the car in front of you is doing 57, we're gonna match that speed, maintain a proper safe gap between the car in front of you. So we wanna make sure that that system is working correctly before we return this car back to the customer. Of course, the first thing that we're gonna do, and like we've done in the past, is hook up our VCI to the DLC and get into the diagnostics. One thing you're gonna notice about GM vehicles is getting them into the, turning the key on, it does take you to press and hold the ignition key for about 3 to 5 seconds to get that to turn on. Some cars are a lot easier. Keep in mind with GM, little tech tip for you, takes a couple seconds of holding that button in to get your key on to be able to communicate with the actual ADASLink. Let's go ahead and move on over to our ADASLink again. All right, we're gonna go ahead and select diagnostics and we're gonna auto ID this vehicle. All right, 2021 GMC Yukon Denali 6.2, we're gonna select that. Please cycle the ignition just like we've done in the past. I'll do that real quick. All right, back to our home screen now on our ADASLink. We're gonna go into ADAS calibration and we are given two choices here, front facing camera and front facing radar. Again, we did a little bit of work. They did the body shop with the front facing radar. They took it off, put it back on. So we're gonna go ahead and calibrate that. Long range, radar sensor module learn. Okay, just like in the past, this will walk you through every step that you need to do so you know how easy it is to do and all the steps that are required. You're gonna see today that we are not going to be using the actual DAS 3000 rack, as this is a dynamic driving procedure that we're going to do. So this one here, anytime the module has been removed or replaced or repositioned or resecured, just like I had said that the body shop had done, is one of the reasons that you would do this, or if you had a TSB or certain DTCs were present. So we're gonna press continue. Before aiming this, again, make sure that there are no DTCs present other than the one that is listed there on the screen. Make sure your tires, just like we've talked about in the past, are properly inflated at the correct PSI. Vehicle's not overloaded. Make sure the surface in front of the radar unit is clean. We had checked and took a look down there at the bottom of where that location is, and it is clean. It's also been replaced, so everything's new down there. Verify the mounting area is not damaged. Body shop already took care of that for us. This procedure will require the vehicle to be driven. And that's what I was talking about we're gonna see. And a lot of cars on the road, we're talking millions of them, require a drive procedure for the radar, and that's what we're gonna watch. So no scan tool must remain connected during the procedure, and it can be, it's going to take anywhere from 10 to 30 minutes before those current, the correct driving conditions are met. So that's where it comes into a little bit of time involved in this one, because you're gonna have to meet the conditions that they're asking for on this. It also says that there's going to be a, probably a service message displayed on the cluster. We'll take a look at that while we're driving as well, so you can see that. All right, so flat and straight road is preferred. We've got to be going over 35 miles per hour during this test, so you're probably going to want to find something like a highway or something in those regards like that. You've got to be able to see lots of street signs. It's got to see different things on the road, and it's also got to see a car. So follow at least one vehicle. Approximately 100 to 165 feet away is preferred when you're doing that. And I'll show you when we're on the drive how you can actually identify that the radar is at least seeing it, so that you know you are being picked, that it's picking up the car in front of you. Avoid heavy traffic and avoid extreme acceleration or deacceleration. And right now it says start engine and be prepared to drive before continuing. So that's important to remember right now. At this point, you do not want to press continue. You want to make sure you're out of the shop and ready to drive wherever you're going to go before you press continue. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and pull this out of the shop here and get ready to start that. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and go find a place where we can do 35 miles or higher and drive this. The only indication right now that tells me it's in actual calibration mode is in the over next to the oil pressure gauge there. We have our adaptive cruise control light. It is illuminated right now. That is telling us I'm in calibration mode. Also, when we're driving, I'll turn on the actual adaptive cruise control and you'll see that it says it is temporarily disabled. That means it's in calibration. One of the things you're going to watch for while you're driving to tell you that it is completed is that light will go out. That is an indication that it is done calibrating. And we're going to watch on the screen what it tells you to do. And we're going to want to follow these actual instructions very carefully when you're doing this. Right now it says start engine and we said be prepared to start to drive before continuing. That's where we're at right now. If you would have pressed continue before you started driving, you would definitely have an error message. It would say it's calibrated, but I promise you, you're going to have an issue once you try to actually drive the vehicle. So we're gonna go head out right now, find a nice spot where we can do the speed that's required and get this thing to get calibrated. So we're gonna go ahead and find our highway next to us. And it tells us right now, drive the vehicle at the required speed. So it'll take us a minute to get there. And we're going to be watching for that adaptive cruise control light to go out. That's our indication. You'll also notice it says once the procedure is completed, to go ahead and pull over, stop the vehicle before pressing continue. That's another important thing to see on that screen and to understand. These procedures can take a little bit of time. 10 to 30 minutes of driving time is required for it to see all of the actual landmarks, signage, vehicles in front of it before it will actually go through and be done calibrating. So it just depends on the road you're on, how long it will take. The more it sees, the more cars you're around, the better you can maintain your distance between a car in front of you, the quicker it'll go. This goes for a lot of the vehicles, again, like Stellantis and Ford, where you're doing the radars as well. We're above 35 miles per hour right now. There are some cars in front of us, and it says we need to be in behind a car. So what I'm going to do is just show you what it looks like, what a car is in front of you. Even in calibration mode, the green little car just showed up, says there is a car in front of us right now. And this car we want to follow for a while. So as you can see, while we're, or maybe you didn't see it, it happens pretty quick sometimes. That light will just all of a sudden disappear, just like it did. It was next to the oil pressure gauge light. It is gone now, which indicates that the radar has calibrated right now. And next thing that said to do on the actual scan tool was to stop the vehicle before pressing continue. Okay, we've pulled over, we're stopped right now. We're gonna press continue. Next thing it's gonna have us do is confirm the functionality of the system. To verify if the system is working, we're gonna watch the adaptive cruise control switch from white to green at speeds greater than 25 miles per hour. We're gonna verify that before pressing yes. And we'll see that on the dash while we're driving. We're above 25 miles per hour. If you look right in between the coolant and the fuel gauge, you'll see where the adaptive cruise control is. Turned it on, turn it off, see it's off now, on, and I'm gonna set it. It says right now, and it went to green. Cruise control is set to 35 miles per hour. It went from white to green as soon as I activated the adaptive cruise control. This indicates that it is functioning normally, and I can press continue on the actual ADAS link. And as you can see, the calibration has successfully completed. We did have a report generated, just like we have with all of our ADAS reports in the past. Again, you can print that copy off. Give your customers a copy of that. Again, that tells them that the calibration has been done. Last thing we're gonna do is while we're on this road, we're gonna verify that it works. Just like any other ADAS calibration that you do, a test drive is always required to verify that it's working. There is a car in front of us. The dash is indicating that our adaptive cruise control is set to 61. It does read the car in front of us, and we have backed off our speed according to the car speed in front of us. So we have verified that the system is operating as designed, and I can safely return it back to the customer knowing that it's working. Thanks for watching this video covering the front radar calibration on this GMC Yukon Denali. Stay tuned. Next time we'll be doing another calibration on another vehicle. Again, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.